There are numerous things that result in a patient needing to have heart surgery today, and that would include a problem with their coronary arteries, blockages of their coronary arteries. Then you have a huge category that's actually growing now where the valves either leak or they're too tight. The third category, although less common but still exists, in which patients have had congenital heart problems that they were born with and now they've grown into adulthood, either having had them diagnosed late in adulthood or knowing that it was there but now needing to have something done about it. A fourth category would be electrical problems with the heart, in which there would be some conductivity problem or rapid heartbeat problem that would result in needing to have specialized studies done and then possible interventions. Traditionally, everybody knows about open heart surgery through what we call a sternotomy, where people, quote, have their chest cracked, which is the typical terminology for that. But basically, it's dividing the breastbone, going through the middle of the sternum, to get access to the heart. And this has served physicians and patients very well for 30, 40 years. We have become more and more comfortable with doing the same types of procedures through smaller incisions. So we have begun a fairly comprehensive program where every patient that comes to our center is looked at initially for a minimally invasive approach, a small incision approach or a robotic approach, one of the two. And if they are candidates for that, then that's how we do them. If we can't do it that way, then of course we offer them and provide them the traditional approach. But every patient first is considered for a small incision and less invasive surgery. I do think it's important today, as we go forward, that patients understand that as we have emerging technologies that are rapidly coming at us, it's important to choose a hospital that has a team that is looking at that. The team is highly specialized and super specialized in the area of coronary bypass surgery or minimally invasive valve surgery. All those are teams of experts that share their particular area of expertise. I bring something to the table as a surgeon, the cardiologist brings something to the table as a surgeon, and then at the end of the day, we have the best plan for the patient with the current and emerging technologies. Probably only about 15 to 20% of centers in the country are routinely doing successful minimally invasive valve surgery, either aortic or mitral or closing holes in the heart or doing electrical work. We understand now that high volumes equate very much to high quality. The centers that are doing higher volumes and the centers that are developing this team approach and a comprehensive commitment to minimally invasive surgery and robotic surgery, utilizing those types of techniques, are the ones that are getting the best outcomes.